a 13th time winner this year, and with it, he will win the MX2 World Championship 2020. He can't believe it.
Since I'm a little boy, you think, you dream about to be world champion one day.
When we start working with Tom 2 years ago, to be honest, even myself, none of us, myself included, couldn't predict that learning curve was going to be that steep.
With Joel, I start from zero because I was nobody.
When we decided for Tom, nobody could understand how we can choose that kid.
You know, KTM win the championships for many years. Almost every year they win. So I was like, oh, I cannot lose that because I'm gonna be the bad guy, you know? So I took the red flag in Valkenwart for the second race. And then I was really motivated to go to Argentina to fight. And then they stopped.
It's been 154 days since the last gate drop of MXGP. We are back, we are safe, and we're ready to go racing again.
And we start again the season with 3 races in 1 week. Quite hard also to train, you know, physically for the recovery after the race. This was really new for everybody.
Vialle is who exits the first turn right up front where he wants to be. Here's your race leader and championship leader, Tom Vialle. Out of the final turn, takes the checkered flag.
He really stunned the whole team, that 3 races in Belgium. We've been prepared to lose points, but to take points there even, that was a big surprise. And win 2 times Lommel, that nobody would have dreamed of.
Back-to-back wins in Belgium, in Lommel, for Tom Vialle. A good jump there, straight away from Tom Vialle. He was half a bike length by the time he got over the steels. Tom Vialle leading the way from Jarno Kiet. It's tense down here in MX2.
I get often asked, of course, but what's the secret? Yeah, the secret's not me. The secret's, of course, the whole team. We are not losing energy in things that don't matter. When I first met Tom and his family especially as well, I was quite impressed by the way they looked at a potential career of their son. If they were going to be a factory rider, that they, for instance, had to be mom and dad, and not the mental coach, and not the physical coach, and not the riding coach. Fred has been a former multiple GP winner. So I was really impressed that he understood that. How the mom is a mom is just fantastic. How the brother is a brother is just fantastic. And how Fred handles that whole family situation, that's the example for many, many parents and riders to follow, actually.
He was third in time practice today, but he was deemed to have stopped on the racetrack. His best time was taken away from him. He now goes to the line last, 29th place for the championship leader on what is already a high-pressure day for the 28.
I went to talk to him and said, like, we can discuss a lot about it and we can get angry and mad. Nothing's gonna change. So why not just focus on that 29 gate pick and get it from there.
Race one, and Vialle right away from the outside, and look at that. Straight into the lead at the very first turn, and bumps Jarno Kiet, his closest rival. And then the motorbike also down at turn one. And he leads, and it's Malkovich in second as they drop into turn two. So talk about adrenaline pumping through the veins of Tom Vialle. He pulls the foxhole shot and he's leading the way from all the way over on the outside gate. And ever since he took the red plate at round two at Valkenswaard, he has not looked back. He's been in some battles. And he's just two corners away. Now he might allow himself a celebration. Tom Vialle will cross the finish line, a 13th time winner this year, and with it he will win the MX2 World Championship 2020. But Tom Vialle cannot believe it. And Tom Vialle, world champion 2020 MX2. November the 4th, 2020, lifts the MX2 World Championship. Mama and Papa Vialle there as well, and what a fantastic achievement for the young Frenchman.
I think we did a great job with all the team. I didn't have so much pressure, and I took good starts, good race always, and that was the key, I think.
It was a nice challenge, and good it worked out. Yeah, I don't regret anything. It's when we saw him riding first, you could see he has some raw talent and really nice style, and yeah, with hard work and a good team, you can achieve it.
We only took it race after race and tried to get better and stronger. And that approach will not change to us next year. We haven't seen the best of Tom Vialle yet.